exciting. That is absolutely awesome behind the scenes of Uzalo. Now, in its 5 years of existence, Uzalo has turned a host of unknown talent into household names. So the drama has also been home to some of South Africa's most established acting talent who've played a major part in creating the magic that viewers have enjoyed. One of their most memorable characters is the character of MaMlambo, played by the gorgeous Gugu Gumede. Now, she is no stranger to the world of acting, and we are delighted to have her in the loft today. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's really amazing to be here.
Oh, we are obsessed with you. And what? I mean, Uzalo is huge. It's basically like the biggest telenovela ever. Did you know that it was going to be that big when you signed on?
Listen, I don't think that any of us had like imagined the magnitude of how big it would be. I think, you know, we're just excited that this was going to be the first show that was filmed in Durban. Yeah. And I think most of the cast is from Durban. I'm from Durban as well. Yeah. So I think that's just all that excited us. We're just like, oh my gosh, is this new show filmed in Durban by Durban actors. Yeah. Also, it's by a woman. It was created by a woman, Gugu Zuma. So we were just very excited. Yeah. And I don't think we really thought it would go this big. So we're very excited that South Africa has received us the way that they've received us.
Like, the majority of people on set are females, like the focus puller, and we're going to actually be meeting all these people throughout the day. Yeah. But basically, it must be so refreshing to be working on a set like that.
It's incredibly refreshing, Jeannie. I mean, it's mainly black women. So it's paved the way for a new culture, you know, black empowerment, woman empowerment. Yeah. And it's amazing for us as young people also to see. And then we see also that we can do it as well. Yeah. So it's been very refreshing, and it's something that we never get used to. Every single day is like, we breathe. Yeah. Like, oh my gosh, this is actually happening. So we're very excited.
And
about
I love that you just referred to yourself as a young person, because we were joking earlier saying the curious case of Gugu.
Oh, really? I'm like Benjamin Button. That's funny.
Because you, in real life, you are super young. But then MaMlambo is like in her 40s.
Yeah, this is a middle-aged woman. At first, it was something that I had to really research. You know, when I started, I think I was like, 25 or something? And so it's an insane scene.
Such a vast contrast.
Such a contrast. But that's where research comes in. And they say an actor prepares. So it's been very exciting for me. I think every time I meet people and they look at me and they go, oh my gosh, you're so young. That's the first thing that they say. And it's like, oh, thank you. Because firstly, if I can actually do it and convince people that I'm an older woman, I'm a middle-aged woman, I think then I've done what I need to do.
Sure.
That's all you need as an actor, to be convincing.
Exactly.
So it's been really fun to do something out of the norm, to do something that isn't me. I think if I had to portray a character that is a lot like me, I would get bored a bit. So this has been something that's completely fun to do.
And you know what is actually quite a fun element to that is by doing this, you've given your career so much more longevity. Like, I think when I started at top billing, I was so young, but my disposition was so much older.
Fast
forward 16 years, I still have a job, and
that's
amazing. I don't really look much different in age.
I've never actually even thought about that. Yeah. You don't. You look
stunning.
But
then you're going to be like 25, 26, but then in 15 years...
I'm hoping I'll start to look younger. I'm hoping it will be the curious case of Gugu Gumede. Then I can possibly get like roles where I play younger, because now I'm like, I'm going to be typecast.
Are you worried about that? Have you already had a problem with being typecast, or is it not an issue yet?
My first role was a younger woman, and I'm still a youngin. I've just been on like the show quite a long time, but I'm still like like I'm still very young in acting, but I had a current role on another show. It's quite similar to MaMlambo, so I was like, okay, I do wish people would see me differently now, because they already know me as an older woman, as a middle-aged woman, a Zulu woman, a woman that is very articulate, as umZulu. So I mean, I do kind of get nervous a bit that they'll only see me as that.
Yeah.
So I think it's just a matter of creating something different, and I think this also gives me something to look forward to, because I want to create as well. I don't just want to be an actor, but I want to produce.
Well, look, so I'm at like, Reese Witherspoon and Nicole Kidman writing that Big Little Lies, so that they could get
now, like, the actor of actors, Meryl Streep, was on there. Can you imagine? So, I mean, can you imagine if I did something and I had, like, the likes of, like, Lelete Nkumalo, whom I've worked with, but can you imagine if she was on my show that I created?
Incredible.
And Gugu Zuma did that for us.
And it's doable.
It is. Gugu Zuma taught us that. Our executive producer, you know, and also Mamitsi Tibedi, these are a powerhouse. Like, these are, like, incredible women who have shown us that it is possible. We don't have to just think and imagine it. We're living it. Every single day that I go to work, I'm like, and I see the sets, and I'm like, this was by a young black woman.
Yeah. So no, I can do it. It's extraordinary. Yeah. And you're not so far off. You are such an amazing actress. Like, just for me to see the contrast between MaMlambo and you, like, you're amazing.
Thank
but you did cut your teeth in a really good, I mean, you learned well.
Yeah.
So you studied in Los Angeles at the Royal Academy of Dramatic Arts.
I studied at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts.
Okay.
The alumni was quite incredible. I mean,
who did you study with? Anyone you had known?
No. Well, currently, it's so funny. I just saw one of the guys who was a year before me, he did Modern Family, and he did what's the show? It's Young Sheldon. And I saw him on there as well, and I was like, whoa, Doc, you're actually doing it.
Yeah.
But I mean, the guys that were before us, it's incredible alumni. But I mean, this is not to take away from what we have now in South Africa. Like,
no,
we have amazing schools like AFTA, which I mean, I think, you know, if I'd known now, like if I'd known then what I know now, I would have gone to AFTA. So I always tell people, I'm very grateful. I'm incredibly privileged to have gone to the school that I went to.
Yeah.
But I think we've got enough, you know, groundbreaking.
And it's different styles anyway.
It's different styles anyway. But it's also amazing to bring that back home.
Yeah, of course.
And I think that's what it's about. You know, wherever you go, I think it's always amazing to come and bring it back to South Africa and to say, okay, this is the style that I've learned. So just infuse it a little bit with what we know here at home. And it doesn't hurt to know just a little bit more.
Listen, you are so fabulous and vivacious. And your energy is just amazing.
You
are a solid Afternoon Express woman. We are so proud to have you here today. So, how good are you in the kitchen?
Girl, I try, girl.
Okay,
I try.
Well, somebody's got to out of the two of us. So, a little birdie told us that Gugu is a lover of anything cheesy and Italian. So, after the break, we prepare a scrumptious cannelloni bake that is sure to hit the spot. Plus, we'll be crossing live to the Uzalo set with Palesa to meet some of the talented cast and crew. And don't worry, if you have load shedding blues, we are streaming live on YouTube as well. So go and visit our social media platforms. And of course, you can also call us anytime during the show on 021-430-9881 if you have any culinary questions or if you just want to speak to our very fabulous guest.